In this session, we will be discussing the checklist of items that should be set up and reviewed before proceeding with setting up your project job contracts. The first area we'll go into is general ledger. In here, under all general ledger accounts, you should go in and make sure you have your retainage receivable account set up in the system. If not, please set it up at this time. Also in general ledger, you'll need to make sure under setup that you have both the user-defined books and user-defined journals needed for contracts. With your construction subscription, these should already be in the system. Just go into user-defined books and confirm that these are already set up. You should see contracts and contracts reversal listed as CN contracts. If not, please set those up now at this time. Then, under journals in the setup of general ledger, under user defined, you should also see a corresponding contracts and contracts reversal journal set up. These journals will then also be tied to those individual books that were set up in the previous steps. If they are not set up, please make sure these are set up as well by clicking Add. Next, we will go over to Accounts Receivable under Setup Configuration. In here, you want to make sure that if you're tracking retainage, accounts receivable retainage for your job contracts, that this is enabled here in the configuration with a checkbox. This is also where you'll define what is your retainage receivable general ledger account. And you also will need to have automatic numbering set up for your retainage invoices. This is required. You should have one already set up in there called AR Retainage Release. This can be edited, or you can add a new one if it's not. For example, under View, you'll see here that they've defined a number structure called ARR and a 5-digit number after that. You can edit this and make it whatever your company prefers to use for a numbering structure. Also on accounts receivable, you do have an optional task to set up customers. And inside those customers, you can set up the default retainage percentage by customer. This is not required, but if you do have a particular customer that is always using a particular certain set percentage, you can come into the customer under Edit. Under the Additional Information tab, you'll notice down in the invoice detailing, you will have a default retainage percentage that you can key in and set up for that customer. The project contract will override this setting, so if there is a unique or specific retainage percentage for that individual contract, it will override this as well. Click Save. And at this time, you should also go into Platform Services under Printed Document Templates, and you should review the default documents that are set up in the system for invoice generation and see if there's any customization needed for these documents for your company. If so, make a note and plan accordingly to get these forms set up correctly so that they will print out exactly how you guys would like them to see. For example, you can come in to Payment Applications. You can click Template. It'll download the payment application form. You can open it up. It'll open up Word. And you can get a quick view of what the form is going to look like and make changes if need be. So for example, this would be your typical AIA type document in the system. After reviewing those documents, you can head over to the job/projects application. And in here, you will be able to set up optional job contract types. And this is a way for you to define and break out your different types of contracts. For example, here, we have a fixed price contract and a time and material contract, the two common types that you can set up in the system. And this is used for reporting and filtering only. The last step would be to come over into the order entry application and make sure that there are the required transaction definitions set up for project contracts. Again, with your construction subscription, this should already come set up but you should still go in and review and confirm that it is there. Under transaction definitions, under setup order entry, you should see one called project contract invoice. If you don't, you can click add. We'll go into edit and take a look at it. Within the project contract invoice, you should make sure that it's on a template type of invoice, workflow category of invoice, and reporting category of contract invoices. And this helps for reporting purposes. We'll also need a number sequence for your invoice. It comes predefined under an invoice sequence called project contract invoice. Just like the retainage invoice document numbering, you can come into here and view it. And you can also edit it and make the numbering structure exactly what you want your company to have it defined as. Scrolling through the options here in the settings, some of the things to look for is you should make sure that line item pricing is checked. As far as transaction posting going, this is going to post to the accounts receivable application. We want to have retainage enabled, and we also want to have job contract billing enabled, and this is a critical box that needs to be checked here. And the update method for job contract totals should read addition. Scrolling through the rest of the items, if you go down to the print section, this is where you're going to define what invoice form you want to use for this transaction definition. So in this case, it's a project contract. We're going to use the payment application form, which we just previewed in the previous step. So if you would like to use a different form for example, your time and material contracts, you would want to set up a separate transaction definition for time and material contracts. And you could simply do that by coming into the project contract and click duplicate. That'll bring over all the settings. And then you just need to come down to the print section and define the form specifically for the T&M billing. Going back up to the top, once you're through the general, you should take a look at the posting configuration. And under the transaction posting AR account mapping, this is where you're going to define the general ledger entry for this type of contract. So for example, for the credit, you're going to select the revenue count that you want to use in the general ledger. In this scenario, it's $4,000 for revenue. And for the debit, you're going to select the accounts receivable account that you want it to post to and code it as an offset entry. So you should make sure this is set up accordingly. You can also secure this document as far as how you want to allow editing, at what stage and deleting. And you can also set up entity settings. So for example, if you have multiple entities, you could have each entity listed here and have a separate numbering structure and also have a separate form that is used based on entity. Once the transaction definition is set up, click save. And at this point, you are ready to start setting up your job/project contracts.